Today, we have to find out the expression or the derivation when the resistances they are connected in series. So what is the expression for the resistances when they are connected in series? In series combination means what? The resistors, for example, R1, R2, R3. In this diagram, there are three resistors are there, and these three resistors are connected one after the another. And such combination is called as the series combination. If you observe, this is what the complete circuit diagram for the resistances when they are connected in series. If you observe some logical symbols you have to find out. For example, this is the symbol, and this symbol is basically used for the to denote the battery or the cell. Second, it is what the key, which is in on state. Third, A is for the ammeter, and ammeter is a device used to measure current in a circuit. These are the symbols for resistor, and resistor is a device used to control the flow of current. Sometimes in normal language it is called as to oppose the flow of current. Basically we use the word to control the flow of current. And one more, this is the symbol, it is called V, and V stand for voltmeter, which is used to measure the potential difference across each resistor. Okay, so when we arrange the diagram, we have the resistors R1, R2, R2, R1, R2 and R3. R1, R2 and R3, they are connected one after another. And that's why they are called as resistors which are connected in series. Generally, in a series, if you observe the characteristics, basically two characteristics are very important if you have to derive the expression for this. What is that? Number one, in a series combination, same current flow across each resistor. This is the first characteristics you have to keep in mind. Okay, first, what I told, same current flows across each resistor. And second is, in a series combination, the potential difference across the combination, for example, C and D. And if you have to find out the potential difference, total potential difference, that is V. So that will be nothing but the potential drop across each resistor. So you have to make sum of all these. If you have to find out the total potential difference across the combination, at that time you have to add all the potential differences which are dropped across each resistor. So इसमें दो चीजें समझ में आ रही है. नंबर एक, यहां पर करंट सेम है, और सेकंड, वोल्टेज डिफरेंट है अक्रॉस द ईच रजिस्टर. सो ये दो चीजें यहां पर मैंडेटरी है. इसके हिसाब से हम लोग अगर बात करेंगे तो एक्सप्रेशन की शुरुआत कहां से होगी? अगर करंट सेम है, आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू मेजर इट, but I want to measure the potential difference. That is very important for us. And to measure the potential difference, we have the formula, the total potential difference V across R1, R2 and R3. Suppose across the resistors R1, the potential drop is V1 plus across the resistor R2, the potential drop is V2. And across the R3, suppose we consider as a V3. Yahan pe likho, let V1 is the potential difference, voltage drop across R1, V2 across R2 and V3 across R3. So in combination, from in between point C and D, agar aapko total find out karna ho, so add all this. So when you add all this, you got the effective potential difference or the total potential difference. Getting? This is called equation number one. Now we have to apply here Ohm's law. But using Ohm's law. Now question is what? What is Ohm's law? सबसे पहले मेन ये चीज़ है कि आपको Ohm's law समझना ज़रूरी है. मैं यहाँ पे आपको बताऊँ. Ohm's law की statement क्या है? If the physical state of the conductor remains constant, the current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to potential difference applied across its two ends. This is the Ohm's law, we know. And in short, we can written it like V is equal to IR. In short, it is nothing but the formula. What is R? R is nothing but a kind of constant. When you have to convert the proportionality into the constant, we take R. So V is equal to IR, or I is equal to V upon R, और R इज इक्वल टू V अपॉन I. ये अलग अलग फॉर्मूलाज हैं जिसको हम लोगों ने रीअरेंज करते हैं. यहां पे मुझे फॉर्मूला यूज करना पड़ेगा, वो वाला ये है, दैट इज कॉल्ड V इज इक्वल टू IR. सो दिस इज व्हाट द ओहम्स लॉ. सो दैट ओहम्स लॉ वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन द लास्ट लेक्चर मेरा. अगर आप इसका प्रीवियस लेक्चर देखेंगे, दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन द ओहम्स लॉ. सो यू कैन क्लैरिफाई दिस कंसेप्ट. ओके, सो यहां पे लिखूं मैं V इज इक्वल टू व्हाट? V इज इक्वल टू IR. इन सेम मैनर व्हाट अबाउट वी वन, तो मैं यहां पे लिखूं आर आर वन, वाई आर वन बिकॉज वी वन इज नथिंग बट द वोल्टेज ड्रॉप अक्रॉस आर वन. What about V2? V2 is equal to IR2. In the same manner, V2 is the voltage drop across R2. And last is V3. It is what? IR3. So put up all this value in equation number 1. We put up all this value in equation number 1. So what it become? It's simply like that. IR is equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. For V, we place the value of IR here. For instead of V1, IR1. Instead of V2, IR2 and so on. So here, R stand for effective resistance. So I am written here RS. What is RS? S stand for? R stand for effective resistance. When they are connected in, S for series. So RS stand for effective resistance when they are connected in series. Now, जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि यहां पे एक चीज सेम है, वो यहां पे लिख दो, यहां पे इन सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन करंट इज सेम. ये प्रॉपर्टी या ये ट्रिक आपको याद रखना पड़ेगी. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस ट्रिक. इन सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन करंट इज सेम अक्रॉस ईच रजिस्टर. दैट्स व्हाई वी ओमिट आर, बिकॉज इट इज सेम. सो व्हाट इज रिमेन? इट रिमेन आर एस इक्वल टू आर वन प्लस आर टू प्लस आर थ्री. So this is what the expression for the three resistors when they are connected in series. Suppose now someone asks you, what about if n resistors, n number of resistors, suppose n resistors if they are connected in series, n resistors if they are connected in series. So what is the expression for such resistors when they are n number? So simply it written like this: RS equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus dot 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 plus Rn. So this is what the expression for resistors when they are connected in series. So very simply, first of all you have to find out the total potential difference, number 1. So use the Ohm's law, apply the Ohm's law for each resistor. As the current is same, you just omit the value of R, and finally what remain is nothing but the expression for resistors when they are connected in series. So this is the formula, and this, like if resistors are connected in series, this expression basically we use to solve the numericals also. So this is what the today's point, resistors when they are connected in series. Thank you.